Hello guys, so today I'm going to be reviewing some of the best PCs out right now. So, from $700 to $1,000. Starting off with the $700 PC, right here we got an HP Pavilion, the gaming desktop, with the G4 GTX, a 1650 Super, with the i3-10100, 8GB of RAM, 256GB, SSD card, Windows 11, it comes with a USB mouse and keyboard, and this is the PC right here. PC has some vents, it has the vents right here, on the corner here, and then, like, it's like a pretty plain design. On the top, it has the on button, on bottom, it has a headphone jack, has four USBs, has looks like a full SD card reader. And then a USB type S cable. And let's see. Here has an enhanced thermal solution. Keep your tower cool even when running demanding games. Here, let's see. 12 inches wide. Here's right there is the HDD and the SSD card. It has the GPU cooler and then a regular fan right there. Super speed USB type A. And has a USB type C. Alright. And then let's see the reviews on this. The reviews are here. 933 global reviews and 77% of them are 5-star reviews. Here it says, easy to set up and works very well, reasonably fast. Only problem I found so far is a bit short on memory. But I knew that from the start. 8 gigs just isn't enough memory. So plan to take it up to 32 gigs. Don't know how well HP customer support is this time. Haven't told us. Haven't had to use them. But in the past it was very poor. Hopefully this PC will last a few years. We'll update review after a few months. This is right here. So the only problem right here is that I only had 8 gigs of RAM. So the only problem is you guys have to update it. To like upgrade the sticks from 8 to 16. Then right here it says, I ordered this computer. It was $600 on March 17th. Given the insane price for graphic cards right now, the GTX 1650 Super listing includes isn't available anywhere for less than $400 right now. I knew I needed to snap on one of these as soon as my $1,400 stimulus payment hit in. I figured it'd be sold out soon, at least for the $600 price. They did sell out within 24 hours of me buying. So this is a good PC. This is actually the PC I was gonna get before, until I got my HP Omen PC, which I'm gonna get into later in the video, and then let's move on to the other PCs right here. Let's see the other PCs. This is actually the PC I have right now. The HP Omen 25L gaming desktop, 10th generation Intel Core i5-10400 with 8GB of RAM. Also with 8GB of RAM, the only problem is you're gonna have to upgrade the 8GB RAM to 16GB of RAM or to 32GB of RAM, or whatever how much RAM you guys like to play demanding games. I have 32GB of RAM because I use it to upload videos and everything. And this has a GTX 1660 Super 512GB SSD card in Shadow Black right here. It's a pretty good build. Right here is the CPU cooler. Right here is just a fan, and there's another fan right there. This is a little vent right here, and then there's a vent on the top as well, but you can't really see it. The front's pretty plain. You could change the lighting of that on the control center. Right here says Omen right here. Right here is the slots for the RAM. I have all the slots to use. I have two Vengeance Pro RAM, the RGB ones. And then right here, it's the same. Let's go to the reviews right here. 42 reviews, and 31 of them are 5-star reviews. It's a 4.5 stars. It says, Great PC so far. The pricing is pretty reasonable for the parts. I would say it's great for a person switching from console to PC. One thing I would like for PC to do is doing 2 8GB of RAM instead of 1GB of 16 RAM. But I would say just buy another stick of 16GB of RAM. Cable management is not, it's pretty decent. The RGB software, Omen Studio Lighting, that's what I'm saying, you could change the lights. It is great, even working with my Razer mouse, not sure about the keyboards. My belief is it has a software, it might work. Also, the Omen Gamer helps you know your temps, download, and upload speed, and I believe helps you overclock. And then right here, it says, great gaming PC, good for anyone who is new to PC or switching from console. Can run almost any game at high to ultra settings. Apex, Destiny 2, Lost Ark, Ark Survival, Warzone, etc. The only downside to this PC, you cannot overclock. Also, you cannot overclock. This PC has locked the BIOS due to prevent damage from overclocking. So, in my opinion, I think that's good that you can overclock the PC. So, the people won't sell it for less. So, it will stay like the same price. So, this is one of the PCs I recommend getting. The Omen. And moving on to the third PC for $1,069. Right here. CyberPower PC. Intel Core i5-11600KF. 16GB of RAM. So this one does come with 16GB of RAM. It has an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2060. 500GB SSD. And it's all black. Right here. It comes with three fans right here. One GPU fan. And has the vents up here. Has two USB cables. Comes with two headphone jacks and one microphone jack. I think this is the RGB to change the RGB lights, and then this is the on button. And it's a pretty good design. I like the way it is. Right here is more vents on the side. And then let's read the reviews. It says right here, Spanish. I got this as a Christmas present. I was super excited as my old Dell was over 12 years old and was showing its age. After setting this up, I fired up World of Tanks. My old Dell was a NVIDIA 1080 Ti. Cut into the case, would run the game at 30 FPS on full graphics settings with zero issues. The only two fans it had for cooling were the GPU fan, which is external original, and the GPU fan. I never went into the BIOS to up the fan speed either. Then a long game, this PC ran 143 FPS average on max graphics. Ran great for an hour and crashed all the way to start. Played again for another 30 minutes and crashed again. After an investigation, I found out the GPU was running over 150 degrees Fahrenheit and the GPU was approaching the 130 degrees Fahrenheit. The cooling on this PC is awful. It's not got much room for the power supply to breathe under the case. All fans are intake only. This just means faster dust collection rate. However, after going into the BIOS and ramping up the speed, all the CPU fans and GPU fans and the crashing fuse, I was able to stave off the crashes a little with this remedy. I flipped the fan on the rear to exhaust and noticed a 5 Fahrenheit drop in temps. This still did not fix the crash, although I was now able to play for 4 to 5 hours without crashing. So right here, the issue is temperatures, is the temperature that's just crashing because of the high temperatures. So what I would say is you need to get more fans or just upgrade the fans. Right here, run smooth and fast, no problems at all. I would recommend, easy to use, just take it out of the box and connect it, and all this list, all its drivers already updated. The only drawback that could be the headlight will be the CPU cooler high temperatures while playing for a long time. Another high temperatures right here. Alright, so that's gonna wrap up the video, and one of the PCs I would recommend you guys to get is this HP Pavilion PC right here. It's good for its price. It comes with a 1650 Super for $726. Or you could get an i5 right here too for $679 right here. With the 1650. With just a regular 1650. But this is still a good price. And if you want to get a monitor with it and a keyboard and mouse, $924. But I would just recommend you getting the PC because it already comes with keyboard and mouse for you. Even though they're plain, it was still comes with the keyboard and mouse. So yeah, I would recommend you. I would recommend you guys to get this HP Pavilion gaming desktop right here. It's good for its price. So yeah, this is one of the hottest PCs in 2022. This is a review. So yeah, thank you guys.